When it comes to music, do you like Drake?
Oh, who doesn't love Drake?
Yeah. Drake just broke another major record, everybody. Yes. The most top tens by any act in single year.
Himself as a legit mainstream star.
Hey guys, today we're going to be talking about the album that made the phenomenal rapper of Brett Grahams, who we all know as Drake. This particular album is titled Take Care. Take Care was Drake's sophomore album after he dropped Thank Me Later, and it was released on the 15th of October 2011. Take Care by Drake is an album that defined his career. It placed him on that pedestal and made him the man of the moment. It's that album that changed his life forever. It's an album we can compare to the likes of The Blueprint by Jay-Z, 2014 Forest Hills Drive by J. Cole, and when we're going to talk about one of the greatest rappers of all time, Marshall Mathers by Eminem, and also Out to Pimp a Butterfly by Kendrick Lamar. These are great, great, great albums by great, great, great artists. And Take Care is just one of those mentioned in this category. After its release, Take Care charted in 19 countries and was number one in 4 different countries. Afterwards, it was 4 times platinum in Canada, 2 times platinum in the UK, and 6 times platinum in the US. Ooh, talk about numbers, bro. And it went on to sell over 600,000 copies of its first week of sales.
All right, so I got my whole family up here. Look at my dad looking all sharp. I got the man that's responsible for me being here.
Moving on, the lead singles were Marvin's Room, Headlines, which we all listened to at that time and still listen to actually. And fun fact, both songs were produced by the most essential producers in Drake's career, Boy Wonder and 40. These guys, apparently they've defined Drake's career and they've produced most of his hits. They're key roles, they're key players in his career, in building his career, and they still work with him to date. Other lead singles like The Mortal featuring Lil Wayne, which actually sold 3 million copies in the US and goes ahead to make it the most successful song on the album. And here's an icebreaker. Justin Timberlake was actually supposed to be on the album, but he was so immersed in his acting at that moment and didn't get to play his part in making history. And also, on Rolling Stone's 500 Greatest Album of All Time charts, Drake's Take Care came in at 95. Guys, 95. Take Care is the 3rd hip-hop album in the US history to chart on the Billboard 200 for over 350 weeks as of 2019. Greatness. That's just greatness. And to talk about the influence of this album on hip-hop, Take Care is the album that brought Drake's blend of hip-hop and R&B into the limelight. He really influenced this blend in such a way that brought out different artists in different times. And also, the soothing blend of R&B and hardcore hip-hop on this album brought about the contemporary trend of blending hip-hop and R&B in earlier years. Artists like Bryson Tiller came up with this sound with the blend of hip-hop and R&B. Artists like Tory Lanez, the list goes on and on. Black, also in the list, came out with the same style. And it was all thanks to this sound, this sonically pleasing sound that Drake birthed with this same phenomenal album. The Weeknd actually played a very big role in the production of this album. He wrote some songs for Drake and he also produced some certain songs on the album. He was also featured on the album, and which was an amazing fit for him. And harder hats like Kendrick was also featured on this album, which later brought him into the mainstream. Personally, Take Care is a certified classic album. According to numbers, according to sales, according to sound, and according to its impact on the hip-hop and R&B fusion. But we all have different opinions, right? And I'd like to know what you think about this take. So you can drop your comments below. You can drop your comments in the comment section and let me know what you think. But Take Care had an effect on the industry and it changed Drake's life forever. And just like the GQ journalist Frazier Tupper said, the older and the newer albums may have been meaner, but Take Care was Drake at his nicest.
Get Familiar will be bringing you more content to get familiar with, so make sure to hang around by smashing that subscribe button. Catch you later and take care.